Now, she's the four-time Olympic champion who's been battling it out on the Challenge Australia. But sadly, last night, it was game over for Emily Seebohm when Emily and teammate Marley were sent home.
Yeah, Emily might not have won the challenge, but she walked away with something even more exciting. Ooh. An Instagram official relationship with fellow contestant Ryan Gallager. And Amy joins us now live. Good morning, Emily. It's always great to speak to you.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Of course, we love having you. Congratulations on your time in the challenge. But more importantly, congratulations on your relationship. Did you ever expect going into the challenge you might walk away with a boyfriend?
Absolutely not. It was not my game plan at all. My game plan was to win. But Ryan won my heart, so I guess I still won the challenge for me, so I'm happy.
Oh, not a bad consolation prize, that's for sure. Hey, you and Ryan were teamed up for the very first challenge on the show. So when did sparks start flying? When did the relationship begin to bloom?
Honestly, the entire time we were just really good friends. We knew that we had each other's back, and I guess in the challenge, it's hard to trust people, and we just trusted each other from the get-go. And I guess after that, we decided to travel, and, you know, it wasn't quite that friendship that we thought, and it was something more than that.
Oh,
that's awesome.
Happy for you, lady.
Yeah, no, it's great. But come here, you were without doubt one of the strongest players in the competition on the challenge. I mean, obviously, you're an Olympian and you're amazing. Did you feel that right from the off, that you were such a target, that you had that target on your back from people?
100%. I think winning the first challenge didn't help. And then after that, winning the next one probably didn't help. But I think for me, it was just, I knew I was going to be a strong person in the game, being so athletic and being so competitive. So I knew that was going to be really hard, but I kind of thought that I would be able to make it to the final. And then I knew once I got to the final that I would be fine. But yeah, it was definitely very hard to get to that. And I'm just happy where I ended up.
I mean, you had the physical element of the game completely covered, but what about the social element? There was so much drama in that house. How did you get through that?
Yeah, look, drama isn't something that I deal with when I go to the Olympics. We have our own lane and no one can get involved in your swimming or your training. So that I found very hard, and there's probably a lot of drama that you didn't quite see. Which I really struggled with. And I think, like, for me, it was just the fact that I wasn't, you know, from The Bachelor or The Bachelorette or Bachelor in Paradise. And outside of that, there was very few people left in the game to kind of help you get through. And that was such a big group of people that kind of controlled a lot of the game with the numbers that they did have.
Yeah. Is that the most challenging part about the challenge? Because I look at stuff like this and like, oh, geez, I'd love to play those games and stuff, but I don't think I'd be able to deal with all that stuff in the house.
Yeah, it was quite full on and something that I haven't dealt with before. It's definitely hard trying to get along with so many people and probably not having that much common ground. Like, I spend my whole time training. I'm not like going out. I don't drink. I don't party. So for me, like, being in the environment where you do that regularly, it was so different for me. But I had the best time and I met some amazing people and met my partner. So it all worked out for me.
And did I just see something in your bed move?
No, there's no movement on that.
Okay, sorry. I thought I saw some movement back there. Sorry, I must have been projecting that. You already have four Olympic Games under your belt, lady. Are you working towards Paris in 2024?
I haven't got back in the pool yet, but I said to myself when it turns January the 1st that I either get back in the pool or I don't. So I'm really excited to see what I choose. And I know that either way, I'm going to have the most amazing life, and I've loved every minute of my swimming, and I could definitely continue because I love competing and I love representing Australia. So, yeah, I mean, I'm excited to see what I finally decide.
Well, you've already made us proud and everyone in the whole country proud, so we can't wait to see what you do next.
Yeah, you're awesome.
Seebohm. Don't miss the grand finale of the Challenge Australia Monday night at 8:30 on 10 Shake. Emily Seebohm, thanks so much for joining us and enjoy the love bubble.
I will, don't worry.
Good on you, Emily. Take care.
Thank you.
All the best.